It's gonna take a whole lot more than Facebook ads to get people to like me. It's Seto from Renderforest, coming at you with part two of our Facebook ad series. Last time we talked about designing your Facebook ads post. If you haven't already seen that video, you can click the link on the screen now or go to the description for that video first. Once you're done watching that first video, then come back to here for the next steps. This time we're gonna look at more details of the uploading process for your Facebook Ads Account Manager page and the uploading process to your Facebook account. Before we go to the Facebook Ads Manager account, there are a few things that you should know about before you get to creating and posting. We talked about this a little bit in our last video, but just as a reminder, there are a few recommendations that Facebook makes to the public before you go ahead and upload for the specs of your post or video. For example, if you upload a still image, it should be as a PNG or a JPEG. They also recommend that it should be at least 1080 by 1080 pixels. Just so that you know, in our first example, we used the Facebook post template that was 2048 by 1264 pixels. When you upload your image to Facebook Ads Manager, it will cut down to 1080 by 1080 pixels. If you would like to download two different versions of the sizes, you can do so here in this page. On Facebook Ads Manager, you'll have the opportunity to also write text along with your post. There is a headline, primary, and a description box, but there is character limitation. So on the screen, we'll put here the character amounts that you have to stay within. Facebook also recommends some things for if you're uploading video to Facebook ads. You have to upload your video either as MP4, MOV, or a GIF. On Facebook ads, they also give recommendations for the video upload for the text that goes along with it, but luckily it's the same requirements for characters as the normal post. So if you want, you can also reuse the same text from your post as you do for your video upload because it's the same characters. You should also know that there's a minimum and a maximum for uploading videos. The minimum is 1 minute, but the maximum is 241 minutes. Please do not upload a video for 241 minutes. I promise you, no one's gonna watch the whole thing unless you're Steven Spielberg. One last thing before we get started on uploading your post and video is to think about whether you want to use carousel or collection ads. I'll talk about more of this in 1 second. The carousel ads are basically 10 images you can use to talk about a product, a storyline, or you can use these 10 images to talk about different features of one product. But you only have 10 images, so use them wisely. Second is the collection ads. It's almost like a hybrid between a traditional text-based post and a carousel. The biggest difference with a collections, though, is that it brings up almost a website within a website for the user. So when they hover on top of it, they can click to see additional features and options for your products. Now we can take a look at the Facebook Ads Manager account. Let's get started. This is the Facebook Ads Manager account page. You can either log in through your personal account or through your business Facebook account. If this is your first time setting up the account, it will ask you for bank account or credit card information before getting to this point. So do that first, then join me here. Okay, so let's get started. The first thing you want to do is click the Create green button on the top left-hand side. After that, choose the type of campaign objective you want. We're just gonna choose traffic for today. And then once you have your new campaign set up, you can then edit the name of it. We're just gonna call this test campaign, for example. Now at this time, you can scroll down to the optimization and turn that on. And this will allow you to put an amount for your budget. Now you can either do a daily budget amount or a lifetime amount over the ad. For this, we're just gonna do a daily amount of $10. And then next we will go to the new ad set. The ad set is the second page in the hierarchy. First is campaign, then it comes ad set. So we're just gonna call this ad set test ad set. Next, you're gonna scroll down. This is when you can choose to either have it as a single date sale ad, or if you wanna have it for a duration or an endless. We're gonna do an example for just a 1 day ad event. Next, you can choose demographics. I will say at this point, there are a lot of different demographics you can play around with, but to keep it very simple and very short, we're just gonna change the age range to 18 to 40 and then continue on. But there are a lot more other demographic options you can choose when you get more familiar. Next, we're gonna change it to manual placements. The reason why we're changing it to manual placements is because our posts and videos are not going to be synced for all different types of feeds. So we're primarily focused on Facebook feeds, not stories or Instagram reels or other types of display options. We're just primarily focused on the feed option. So we're going to turn all these off. We're going to click all these off and then just make sure that feeds is the only one that is checked off for this example, just to keep it simple. Okay, so we're going to scroll down until we get to the cost control. Now, I don't have this option at this moment, but in some cases you can do a cost control and then click next, and then we will go to new ads. The ad is the final of the three in the hierarchy. So we made a Facebook page example for La Cafe, and then we're just gonna name this ad, we'll just call it test ad. We're gonna scroll down, and then this is when you can choose, like I was talking about, the carousel or the collections. And we're just gonna add our media. So this one is just gonna be the post, the still image basically. So we're gonna upload our image that we created and we're gonna use the original recommended, click next. Sure, we'll let them use the enhancements, why not? And then after that, you can start to edit your posts with your text. This is where you can edit your primary text, your headline and the description. So for the primary text, we're just gonna say bonjour with a big old exclamation point. Next, we can go ahead and edit the headline and just make sure that you are staying within your character limitations, so don't go too crazy. So for this headline, we're gonna say, get an iced coffee for $1.89 on July the 14th, great. Okay, so for the description, you can put either store information, your hours, additional links, but I'm just gonna put Happy Bastille Day to keep it simple. And if you look on the right-hand side, it'll give you live updates so you can see what it looks like on the right side. You can see under where it says La Cafe Bonjour. And then when we go further, you'll see the actual post pop up. Here's where you'll put your website information. So we don't have a website for this fake business, but we're just gonna put our regular one for renderforest.com. And if you wanna make sure that the link works, just click preview URL. Okay, so next you can either do options with languages, you can do tracking, but we're just gonna make sure that this is saved and then go to the next step after this to keep it simple. So we're gonna go to the test ad set, click duplicate to make things easier because all the settings are pretty much gonna be the same. We're gonna stick with the original campaign, click duplicate. Okay, so this made a copy of exactly what we just made. So we're gonna name this one the video so that we know that everything under this is gonna be for the video. And the next ad, we're gonna call it test ad video so that we know the top one is for the posts and the bottom ones are for the videos. It's really important that you keep the labels succinct and straight so that way you know when you look at the analytics later, you can tell where it's coming from or the numbers are pulling from. So we're gonna call this one test ad set post. We're gonna call this test ad post. Okay, so let's go back to the video. We're gonna go to the video ad, and then we're gonna scroll down to find where the post is, and we're gonna change the still image to the video. So we're gonna click add video. We deleted the old one, we're gonna click add video. We're going to pick our media to upload. We're just gonna do the original one. You can preview it if you want at this time. Click done. And then you can also check at this time to make sure that your primary headline and description text is all correct. So if you wanna make any edits, now is the time to make an edit to any of those. And if you look on the right-hand side, you can see the preview. So you can scroll down, make sure your website link is correct. And then if you want to do tracking a language, you can do that at this time, but we're not going to keep it simple. Again, make sure it's everything saved and you can close out. This automatically saves, so you don't have to hit a save button. Okay, next we're just gonna make sure that everything is in line. We have our campaign and all of our ads fall within this one campaign. You can have multiple campaigns, but we're gonna have different ads, but under just one campaign. So here you see the ad set for video and post, and these are the different ads. One ad for the video, one ad for the post. And that's pretty much it. At this point, you can review to make sure that there are no errors because Facebook Ads Manager can be pretty temperamental. So make sure that there are no errors, go to the very end, then click publish. If you're doing your 2021 Facebook ads revamp, there's a few things you want to keep in mind. Be aware that there is a waiting period for when you click publish to when your customers and audience will actually see your post online. People say it's about a day, so if you want to have your Facebook ads available to view, let's say on a Monday, you want to make sure that your Facebook ads is posted to your Facebook ads account by at least Sunday or Saturday, so that way Facebook can review it before it goes to the public. If you're learning Facebook ads as a beginner, don't be afraid to play around. After you post your ad, wait a few days and check back on the analytics to see what's going on. You can try different options in the future to see what works best for you and your company. Be sure to monitor your Facebook account after you post your ad. You might get comments or replies or messages due to your ad, so make sure that you're keeping tabs on that as well. Facebook ads managers, listen up. This promo code is for you. It's a thank you for sticking with us so far. You can use the promo code that appears on your screen now and the link to go toward your first paid subscription. You're welcome. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial and that it helps you with your future campaigns. If you got something out of this, please be sure to like, share, subscribe, and ring that bell so you get future notifications. If you have any questions about this video, feel free to leave a comment below, or if you have a suggestion for an upcoming video, you can also put in the comments. Au revoir!